Alexei Bondarenko of Russia was in first after the first rotation here in the parallel bars.
If you take a look at this opening sequence, very cleverly designed to earn a maximum bonus points, a hop pirouette on the end. Watch this move going in. Now the little shaky there. He needs to connect all of these moves together in a series to get the maximum bonus. That's good so far. But watch this tricky move from the side into the middle with a three-quarter pirouette. That's tough.
Wow. Tough. I'd say that trick looked impossible.
He does really hard routines on almost every piece of equipment. He tends to be just a little sloppy, though. A very beautiful back toss. This was the cleanest part of the exercise, and he connects right from that to the dismount. Doing those two moves back to back earns him 2/10 bonus.
And his score, 9-3-7-5. And after two rotations, Bondarenko now in a three-way tie for first, including American Blaine Wilson. Ivankov is in fifth, Nemov seventh after two rotations. Along the beautiful shore. Welcome back to Lausanne. This is Alexander Beresh of the Ukraine.
And boy, this is a terrific event for him. He's in the hunt for the medals here today, and he's coming up on one of his strongest. He's gonna do a handspring and a double front somersault. Oh, what a landing.
Amazing.
My gosh, it's so hard to flip over three times and then find the floor. Look at this.
The level of difficulty is amazing. They'll score this from a 10.0, and look at the landing. No deductions there.
9-8-1-2. That has to help his standings. Nemov on the rings. Keep in mind, he's coming off of January shoulder surgery.
This is certainly his most vulnerable event. I thought he got a very generous score in the preliminary rounds here. The judges have been giving him the benefit of the doubt on some of these strength moves. This is way too high. He needs to be much lower in that move. These swing elements are good. His hand guard
broke.
The leather hand guard broke.
Wow. That's it.
Oh, my gosh. Now, this never happens in a major international competition. Watch to the left of your screen. Watch the chalk snap when his hand guard breaks. Now, according to the rules, if a gymnast can complete his exercise in 30 seconds, he has 30 seconds to get a new hand guard, get it out of his bag, get back up there, and complete his routine. Well, he doesn't have another one ready. This is devastating. He's totally out of the running now.
6-8-2-5. No shot at a medal now for Nemov. Now Blaine Wilson of the U.S. tied for first currently.
Blaine has the potential to score very well here. He's very aggressive. This is a key combination right there at the beginning. This young man is having one great competition. Started off on two of his best events, rings and vault, and he is cranking through this parallel bar routine. Oh, yeah.
This competition has elevated his gymnastics up one notch. He's always been aggressive, but now it's like he fights for every single perfect skill to not give away a tenth of a point.
You're right, Kathy. Look at the position in this pike double back somersault. I wonder if he knows that no American has won a medal in the all-around competition at the World Championships since 1979 when Kurt Thomas did it.
9-5-6-2. Yes, Blaine Wilson of the U.S. very much in medal contention here in Lausanne. We'll return with more of the World Gymnastics Championships after this message and a word from our ABC stations. The 2004 Summer Games. Bondarenko of Russia now, tied for first after two rotations.
You never know what he's going to come up with here. He has some big moves. He crashed terribly twice in the team competition for Russia. Watch this move here with a full twist. Oh. In the team meet, he landed right on the bar in his rib cage. At just 19 years old, I think this guy has tremendous potential. He already does full difficulty routines almost everywhere. He cleans up, gets a little more style.
Oh, that was stylish.
He's got the stuff, man.
The reigning Russian national champion in the all-around.
And you can tell he can have good form. Just once in a while, he completely loses it. But when you look at the outrageous difficulty that he's throwing at such an early age.
He won the national championships in Russia, the Russian Cup, by 2.5 points. And it's because of moves like this. It's a full twisting reverse hack. Look how close he came to the bar. And yet it didn't faze him. He's not afraid of those really hairy moves.
Bondarenko score 9-0-2-5. Next up on the pommel horse, Ivankov of Belarus. Now we've been telling you about his incredible story, rupturing his Achilles tendon mere days before the start of the Summer Olympic Games. One can only imagine the grueling hours in the gym it took to get back into world-class shape. But Ivankov was up to the challenge.
Sometimes it was like that. I don't want to do gymnastics anymore. It's like, I can't. But next day, you wake up and say, no, man, you can't do it. You have to do it. And I try to be best, even now, after my surgery. And even after what, you know, what happens in Atlanta. I believe in my future, so I believe in myself, and I try to be best. That's my opinion, that's my motivation.
It's hard to believe this is his first major international competition since his injury.
And one of the reasons he's a favorite here is all of his scores are between 9-4 and 9-6. He has no weaknesses. Pommel horse is an excellent event for him. Very nice body position. Extremely difficult opening sequence there.
Hardy's so well prepared for this competition. Everything is just picture perfect.
His form is exquisite. It's a really beautiful sequence here as he's...
Oh, no!
I can't believe that happened. Everything was going beautifully. That's the thing about the pommel horse. You can be swinging beautifully. There's such a small room for error. One little slip and you're standing on the ground. That's a shock.
No one more shocked than Ivankov.
Oh, we got to see if his all-around chances are affected with this. I mean, anytime you fall in a major competition, you might as well write it off. Let's see what happened here. He's doing the flares, and his hand, his left hand, was just a little off the side of the horse.
Still respectable 9-1.
That is amazing. He tried a lot of hard tricks, and the judges certainly rewarded him for doing a lot of difficulty in that routine.
Now Japan's Tsukahara in fourth after two rotations.
Beautiful sequence. Here comes the big release moves that everybody's doing. Double back over the bar. Whoa, right on the end of his fingertips.
His father, the legendary Mitsuo Tsukahara, sitting out in the stands, just skipped a few heartbeats there.
Now, the toughest part of this double back over the bar is placing it just where you want it so you catch at one complete arm's length away. Watch this. He's totally extended. He catches right exactly in perfect position to swing out of it.
And Tsukahara's score, 9-2-1-2, dropping him to fifth in the standings after three rotations. Blaine Wilson of the U.S. in first place.